Hale, today we're going to talk about proving two triangles to be similar. It's very close to when we prove two triangles to be similar, and we're going to use the ideas that we talked about in lesson 27, and we're going to talk about some special similarity theorems. So there's three similarity theorems, less than when we have congruence. The first is angle-angle. That's if I have two triangles and I know that in those two triangles, two of the corresponding pairs of angles are congruent, then I know that those two triangles are similar. And attached to the sort of abbreviation of the names, you'll see I put the similarity symbol, and that's because the next two are going to look similar to the congruence theorems. The next one is side angle side. So like I said, side angle side is a congruence theorem. So when you write this out, you should put the similarity symbol so I know that you are telling me the correct thing. So it's very similar. No pun intended when I use the word similar here. If I have two pairs of sides, corresponding sides, and they're in proportion, meaning their fractions are the same as each other, their fractions are equal, and I also have the angles between those sides congruent, then I have side angle side similarity, and I can say that the two triangles are similar to each other. And last, if I have all three pairs of sides, corresponding pairs of sides in proportion, all the fractions are the same, they're similar by side, side, side. So I don't need to know anything about the angles. So we're going to test to see if these two triangles in this picture are similar, and if they are, we're going to state the theorem that tells us they're similar. So I'll look first at the angles. The only angles I know anything about are the ones right here. And I know they're congruent because they're vertical angles. And it looks like they're between some sides here. So I can write these fractions and see if they're equal. So I wrote 39 divided by 16 and 40 divided by 16. And they give me two decimals that are not exactly the same, which you probably would have guessed by writing the fraction. So because I don't know anything more about the angles, I have two pairs of sides that don't have the same ratio, I'm going to say that these are not similar triangles. This pair of triangles, I know about the sides. I don't know anything about the angles, so I won't be able to use angle-angle similarity. I won't be able to use side-angle-side similarity. So I'm either going to find out that these are not similar triangles, or that they are, and I'll use the side-side-side theorem. So I'm going to match up the smallest sides, the middle sides, and the biggest sides. Then I'm going to write the fractions and see if they give me the same decimal every time. And in fact, they do. They all give me 0.16 repeating. So because all three pairs of corresponding sides create the same fraction, they're proportional, these two triangles are similar by the side-side-side similarity theorem. And I can say that without knowing anything at all about the angles being congruent. But you could now conclude that the corresponding angles in these two similar triangles are congruent to each other. So go ahead and pause here and try this one on your own. So this is similar to one that we did, the first one we did together. I have a pair of angles congruent because they're vertical angles. I don't know any of the other angles here, and I know about two pairs of sides. So basically, I'm going to check to see if these sides make the same fraction, and then I'm looking at side angle side similarity if that happens. So when I do 8 over 28 and 14 over 49, I get the same decimal. That means that these two pairs of sides are in proportion. The angles are congruent that are between those sides. So this angle here is between these two sides. This angle here is between these two sides. So this is an example of side angle side similarity. And because I didn't do one of these examples with you, I'm going to give you a free freebie you do answer. So all you have to do is type the answer in. I'm going to tell you what the answer is. So all you need to do is make sure you type the correct answer into the Google form and get your credit. I don't know anything about the sides in these triangles. So I can't have side, side, side. I can't have side, angle, side. But what I do know is that angle T and angle J are congruent. Angle K and angle U are congruent. And this is an example of the angle-angle similarity theorem. So angle-angle similarity is your answer. You can do AA squiggly. You can write angle-angle similarity. Type that into the Google form, submit it, and we'll do some practice in class, and I'll answer some questions.